Look.
Well, it's got so smelly.
Great. We'll make the rope longer.
In the previous episode, we camped at an altitude of 2,635 meters, an experience memorable in itself. From there, we successfully ascended the breathtaking Stellihorn, a peak rising to 3,436 meters. The journey was far from easy, especially the last few meters, where our heavy backpacks added to the difficulty. I'm extremely proud of Karen, who showed incredible strength, especially after almost 2 years without practice. Yet the adventure was far from over. We had to descend the steep and demanding southeast flank of Stellihorn before crossing the ridge leading to Jazihorn. Then we faced the equally steep descent of the north face of Jazihorn. Each stage of this adventure was filled with intense emotions and challenges, making this experience unforgettable. We begin the descent, and my initial apprehension turns out to be a bit exaggerated. Taking a few minutes to assess the situation and make decision proved helpful. The ridge leading to the starting point of the descent is quite wide, making its crossing less difficult than I initially feared. First, we will go this way, then follow the snowfield here. Then we turn left, continuing along the snow until we reach the rock formation and the ridge. In the end, it's not as difficult as it looks. Everything should go well.
Bob loves to challenge me.
Karen the Alpinista.
He loves to challenge me.
Karen the Alpinista.
The descent turned out to be steeper and more complex than anticipated. We lost a lot of time, to the point where Bob considered spending the night on the ridge, as reaching Jazihorn before nightfall seemed unlikely.
We go there and we follow the Roxla and we will join the ridge. Nice busy place in the winter. How are you, car?
Okay.
It's not scary?
It is.
Fortunately, we have passed the most difficult part of the descent, which is a huge relief. However, our day isn't over yet. We still have to cross a thin ridge to reach our planned bivouac site.
Car was just here on the top of this stuff. You can see our footprints. Karen is a bit crazy. And we can see the crosser.
Bob is crazy, he's taking me all these scary paths. Oh, I just came down here.
As the ridge narrows, it's crucial to firmly anchor our feet with crampons in the snow to avoid slipping. Unfortunately, I didn't put enough force into my steps and ended up slipping.
No.
Bob yelled to warn me not to sit back on my knees, but it was already too late. Thankfully, with my left hand and my pole, I managed to anchor myself in the snow and stop my fall. Bob's shout alarmed me more than the slip itself. He moved forward to position himself better to catch me in case of a fall. In the end, everything turned out fine, and we only had a few dozen meters left to reach our spot for the night.
This is our bivy place for tonight. And tomorrow we get to Jatihorn and down.
We navigate the last few meters, which are particularly difficult, but the precipice on our right serves as a constant reminder to be cautious. Finally, we arrive at our planned bivouac location.
So, Ka is completely crazy.
I just followed this crazy man.
She made me climb this mountain behind us. She's mad.
Oh, is it not filming? Bugger. Can I push the button? It's all right, Bob's just making a flat area for our tent.
It is essential to carefully level the ground for setting up the tent, especially when the snow is hard. This prevents the mats from slipping during the night, which would be very uncomfortable. Taking the time to properly prepare the ground ensures a more stable and comfortable sleep.
So looking forward to a nice coffee and a soup. We need to get snow to melt. Let's see something that's clean. Be good. Yep. I couldn't believe when Bob said, we've got to go down that bit. And because all the way up, he's going, oh, it's easy the other side. It's easy the other side. People ski down there. I don't know where, because, oh my goodness, when we got up there and I saw where I was going to have to do.
Yeah, it was not too bad. But if I told you that it was not so easy, it was easy, but not really easy, you would say, no, I don't go.
Yeah. I had to go back down the other way, which was scary too.
That you can push.
He just likes to push me.
Very, very far, because what you did, not lots of people would do it in the winter.
And the sun's setting over there. It's actually, it's not showing it as beautiful, but it's lovely pinks. And just looks amazing. It looks like there's a sea of clouds all over there, with rocks just poking out. It's just... oh, amazing, beautiful, incredible. You mountains are so beautiful. It was easier to put the tent up today. Ooh. Hope we have to get some of these stones here. Hope. It'll be good for me. Hey. Put me back afterwards, just to be here on your mountain. Yeah, there's one. There, you're nice. Lovely. No, it's too big. Hair's really hard, but you literally walk over there.
To dig.
And it's really soft. Bob's got that in. Got a couple of stones.
Well, we are lucky that it's not windy, because here...
could be very windy.
We'd be not able to stop here.
Huh? No. Oops. Oh, Bob's heating up some snow for us.
My favourite activity.
Yeah, not. Oh, it'd be so nice to have a coffee. And then a
hot
soup.
It was a hard day.
Bloody hard.
Today and scary.
Yes, for me. Hopefully the weather will be good tomorrow.
Well, I will check later on my satellite stuff now, because there is no network.
Shame.
So what are you drinking, Ka?
Well, I'm having coffee at the moment.
And I have a soup.
And I'll have soup after.
We need to drink lots of water tonight. Well, this is our tent. Beautiful place. Yeah. Here we just cooked, ready to go to bed.
For the first time, I managed to capture the lights of distant cities at night with my new camera. This success really makes me satisfied with my new purchase. After having a good coffee and soup, it's time to take care of my feet. As mentioned earlier, I forgot to protect my feet at the start of the hike, and the straps of my crampons were too tight, causing significant blisters. For those who are squeamish, I suggest skipping the next sequence of the video.
Poor Bob, he's got, oh my God. What a blister. Ah, that is going to be so painful. Ow. Unlucky, my shoes are really good. You should get Mindles again, because they didn't give you blisters, did they, Mindles?
Yeah, it's there. Oh, Peter.
Stick it back on. Oh. Oh my God, that's going to be really painful.
What you see is not just my skin, but also a protective layer I applied over it. Sadly, too late. The damage was done, but I still managed to keep going despite the pain, thinking of climbers enduring much worse, which gave me the courage to continue.
During the night, a few snowflakes fell. We suddenly woke up around 11:30 p.m. Winter nights in a tent seem endless. We decided to make some coffee to rehydrate. Upon waking, we thought there was no sun, but after opening the tent, we were pleasantly surprised by the brightness outside.
If we love to be here, is because we can see all these beautiful landscapes. We just above the clouds level, and here you have a 4,000 meter peaks in clouds. There are at least four, and this is the mountain we did yesterday. It's quite impressive, actually. Voila, Jazzy Horn and the sunrise and all these clouds around. Voila. And our tent is just here. So today we just go here to Jazzy Horn. We go down, and after we follow the valley down to Saas-Almagell. Voila. It's not too cold, because there's no wind. But it's easy here to go. Look at this mountain. The sun. It's crazy. Yes, it is. We can even see the moon. It's crazy. Not sure that we can see it, but we are at 3,190 meters.
Amazing scenery. And then Bob, there he is.
Today for the breakfast,
we have got puree de pommes de terre à la viande hachée, so mashed potatoes with mincemeat.
So here we have a Jazzy Horn, Jazzy Luke. We slept over there last year, or 2 years ago, and we were walking here, from the lake.
We begin to pack up our camp. Bob and I always share tasks. He takes care of the cooking, setting up and taking down the tent, while I manage the sleeping arrangements and our personal belongings. This balance of responsibilities makes our expedition routine much easier.
There, we are leaving our bivy place.
Yeah.
Voila, just the stones left. Yeah. And are you ready, Ka?
I think so.
Yeah?
Do you know what's over there? Over the hill.
Ah, it's easy. It's easy, car.
We reluctantly leave our bivouac spot. Its location in the middle of the ridge was exceptional. Perched on a small island amidst a sea of clouds and bathed in the reddish rays of the morning sun, we were enveloped in an amazing setting. This place seemed like a little piece of paradise for us. It's our third day of hiking. Fatigue is setting in and the altitude isn't helping. We move slowly, taking frequent breaks. Fortunately, the ridge isn't very challenging and there's only one slightly more delicate passage over the box.
Sit down. We rest a bit. Yeah, we need to take off the rope. We just took off our down jacket because it was too hot. We go.
We reached Jazihul. I admit I slightly deceived Karen. I hadn't mentioned to her before we set off that we would be passing through Jazihul after Stelihul. 2 years ago, during our first ascent, she had found this ridge too challenging. If I had told her we were going to take it in the opposite direction, she probably would have hesitated to embark on this adventure. Today, I'm proud of her and her achievement. Well done, Karen.
So, where are you, Ka?
We're at Jazihul. We got here.
So it's the second summit on this trek, or hike.
Most I've done in,
and,
in a hike.
We were over there.
Yeah,
you don't turn.
Yeah,
here, in the summit. So we go back? No?
Sure. And it might be different going, I don't know if it's worse going up.
Yeah.
It's really scary, whichever way. We take a brief break before starting the descent. The first few meters are steeper than expected. I will descend first, allowing Bob to secure
go
me with the
left.
Rope. Once I reach a safer spot, then it will be Bob's turn to descend.
Go on your left. You find the right place, I don't know, maybe lower where you want. Behind you, you have a rock, maybe you can sit down on it.
That's Bob's turn to come down.
Karen becomes a mountain god. She did this.
Oh, going down. We begin the long descent from Jazihul, aware that there are no major difficulties remaining until we reach the parking area. However, we continue to be cautious, as surprises are always possible in the mountains.
Yeah.
These are footprints I follow to safety. My Bob leads me to safety. Thank you, Bob.
So here is the path behind the Jazihul we took 2 years ago. You can see the sticks.
During the descent, we share memories, making this return a pleasant moment of reflection. Bob decides not to go all the way to Antona Pass to shorten the journey. Therefore, we take a shortcut, but the terrain quickly becomes steeper. We hope this will be the last challenge of our adventure.
Voila, we arrived to kind of ridge. We will see what is behind, but I see a cairn here, so we are on the right way. Ka will replenish her water reserve.
This marks the end of the second part of our hike. Subscribe now to join us on our adventures, where breathtaking landscape and thrilling moments await you. Discover the power of will. Leave a like, comment, and share your own experiences with us. We can't wait to hear about your adventures.
Really last meters, we can see our car next to the shed. And now, voila, we arrived. Great. 3 days. Oh, we did it.